very late.
Coming. Darling, I'm so worried about leaving you on your own all weekend.
Don't worry, I'll be fine. I told you.
No, you're useless at looking after yourself.
You've left enough food in the fridge to feed the Foreign Legion.
I know, it's only frozen cannelloni.
I love cannelloni.
Hello.
Oh, hurry up. Got over an hour's drive, and you know how your mother panics if anyone's a minute late.
Are you sure you can't come with me?
She's much happier seeing you on your own. I can get some work done. Get a move on.
All right. Will you bring my case down, and I'll just check you've got everything you need.
Right. They told me, but what
the matter?
Nothing. hope you like it. It's just...
something you haven't told me?
No, not at all. Just got to get used to different plans.
Oh. Well, why don't you take my case back upstairs and I'll make sure you've got everything you need in the kitchen for the girl.
Yes. Right.
Are you sure your mother doesn't need you?
Quite sure.
Oh, God! Oh, good.
Oh. And Robert called, he's on his way.
Oh, good.
God.
Darling!
Darling!
Thank God you're still here.
Of course you would keep me away.
Where's Merlin?
Upstairs.
And your mother?
Bed with flu.
And where are you tonight? Oh, you're my angel. This is crazy, you know.
Oh, well, he invited you. I didn't.
But we'll have to be so careful.
Oh, I know. Oh, I'm just so glad I found out you were coming.
You was the only reason I did.
Oh.
Oh.
What was
going on?
Right in it.
Right in what?
Use your brain, Robert.
Oh, yes, of course, something.
She's on the way. She'll be here any moment.
I'm sorry, I thought she had the flu.
Oh, the girl, the girl!
The girl, the girl!
Right, she's coming here. She was supposed to be on the same train you were on.
Really?
Yes, really.
Oh, I see.
You didn't, did you?
Did what?
See her.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, you'd have known her if you'd seen her.
Really?
Yes, knockout. I was supposed to pick her up at the station.
Oh, God, you are right in it, aren't you?
That's why I need your help.
My help?
Yes.
How can I help?
I want you to say she's yours.
My what?
Mistress.
My
guess?
No.
Robert?
No.
Oh, Robert.
No.
Why not?
I already have a... No.
It's the only way out.
No. It just wouldn't work. I mean, I don't know her. I don't want to meet her. And if I did, I couldn't just bring her here. I mean, what would Jacqueline say?
Why should Jacqueline care?
Oh, Jacqueline's my... book.
Man, you've got a perfect right to have a girlfriend.
Jacqueline knows I haven't got a girlfriend. I've never mentioned a girlfriend.
You've got a private life, haven't you?
Well, that's my affair.
Exactly, and this is your affair.
No, I'm sorry, it won't work.
Why not?
Well, I don't know anything about her. A whole weekend together, pretending to be lovers, Jacqueline would see through it in a second.
Why should she?
Well, for one reason, why didn't we arrive together?
Oh, she missed the train, she caught the next one.
Oh, for another, why don't I seem to know anything about her?
I'm taking Jacqueline off to the village. Give you time to get to know each other.
Well, I mean, we don't sleep together.
You do?
Well, how about... What?
Look here. Hello. Oh, Susan, my darling. Where are you? Still at the station? Oh, dear.
Yes.
I'm sorry I'm not there. Some of the trick is turned up. Yeah, Jacqueline's still here. She had to cancel a trip to her mother's. No, you don't have to go back. It's all right, I've sorted something out.
No, you haven't.
Yes, do you remember my friend Robert I was telling you?
No, she doesn't.
Yes, the one who's staying here too.
No, he isn't.
Well, he's agreed to pretend that you're his girl.
No, he hasn't. Give me that phone. Give me the phone.
But since you're here, we may as well have it out into the open.
What have you told him?
I haven't told anybody anything.
Yes, he has. But why do you deny it? She's your mistress.
What?
Yeah.
Don't listen to him.
He doesn't want to talk about it in front of you.
Don't listen to him, Terry.
Well, I...
There's no problem, you see. We're all grown up here, aren't we? Nothing to be ashamed of.
Well, he's actually talked.
Yes, he did. And I thought it's perfectly acceptable. Yes, I did. So admit it.
All right. I admit it.
When I admitted it to you, and you admitted you found it acceptable.
Why?
Acceptable?
Exactly.
Well, I must say I'm astonished.
Why?
Well, that he should have told you.
Why?
Well, about him.
And... Susie.
What?
Susie.
Who's Susie?
She is. Tell her, Robert.
Who's Susie?
She is.
Who is?
She is. She's different. Come on, Robert, old man. There's nothing to be ashamed of. Her name's Suzanne, Susie for short.
Is this true?
She's a model.
I don't believe it.
Why not?
He has a mistress called Susie, who's coming for the weekend. That's unbelievable.
Yes.
No, it's not. You and I spent lots of weekends together before we were married.
They're getting married!
I didn't say that. They're just very friendly. I said I'd be delighted to see them for the weekend, and then when he found out you were going to be here, he got all silly about telling you.
Bet he did.
You understand, don't you?
Oh, I'm getting to.
You don't object, surely?
Oh, can I possibly object to?
You sound a bit prudish, my darling.
Prudish me? No, you can have half of the chair, therefore I can.
There you are.
So, where is she, this Susie?
She'll be here soon. She missed the train they were coming on and rang to say she'd be on the next one. That was her on the phone just now.
Oh, see. You had it all organised between the pair of you, didn't you?
Oh, had we known you weren't going to be on the bus, I mean your mother's, we'd have consulted you naturally.
Naturally. Terrific.
There you are. That wasn't so bad, was it? Jack, now, you relax here while we go and do the shopping.
Can I
come
with you?
No. Moment. He must be here to welcome her, mustn't he, darling?
Oh, yes, he must be here to welcome her. Well, now this is going to be a major social occasion. I suppose I'd better add some things to my shopping list. Like a rat poison.
No problem. You won't be needing this now.
I'm going to need a drink, I know that.
Can we allow you to do your stuff and I will help yourself?
Why not? Poetic justice, I suppose.
What?
Don't worry about it.
You better make sure you get plenty more of this. I've got a feeling it's going to be a very long night.
And a boy.
Well, are you ready? Is love a boy staying or going?
Oh, he's staying. He's going to telephone. He cancelled his appointment in Paris. Aren't you, Robert? Right, let's go then.
You bastard! No one's going to do it.
Jackie, I promise you, things are not what they seem.
Oh, but what are they then?
Well, it's just that I thought... Look, just remember this, my darling. She is not what she seems to be.
She's a transvestite?
No, it's just that we oh, God!
He won't help you.
Listen, my angel.
Don't you angel me. Save your angels for your scooty-clooty.
Jackie,
is this my house?
Yes.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Susan.
what you expected?
Not at all.
But?
I mean, I'm not at all surprised. You got it very quickly.
Yeah, yeah, I got a lift.
Ah, yes.
Are you going out?
What?
You've still got your hand.
Oh! Yeah, how do you do? I'm Robert.
Robert?
Yeah, Bernard's...
Oh, yeah, yeah, it's when you're staying the weekend.
That's right, yes.
Yeah, yeah, he told me all about that.
Yes, I know. He asked me to meet you. Sort of, yes, say
oh,
meet you.
Where are they?
Yeah, well, they've gone into town to do shopping for this evening. And I'm to, yes, introduce and show you. And
so, you can show me what's what, then?
What's what?
You know, where everything is.
Well, yes, okay, but I mean, that can all wait. First of all, I think it's more important we get to know each other first.
Get to know each other?
Well, yes, I mean, it's going to be a very big evening, especially now, you know, everything's got to be prepared.
Well, don't worry about that. You told me on the phone what to do, I can handle everything.
You can?
Yeah, it's that kind of affair's a doggle for me.
Really?
Yeah, it's going to be quite a party, isn't it?
Party's not the word. I mean, especially down his wife's here as well.
Wife?
Yes, yeah, well, she was meant to be miles away, but she changed her mind at the last moment.
Why do she turn up one way or another? Although it'd be a lot easier for me if they didn't.
Well, I'm sure it would, yes.
They do get in the way, rather.
So it would seem.
But don't worry about wives, I usually get on very well with them.
If you don't mind my saying, you don't seem very concerned by all of this.
Why should I be? This kind of affair's a doggle for me.
You mean it's happened before?
Well, of course it happens all the time. But by that time, there are far more difficult occasions than this.
Really?
Yeah, family parties, get-togethers, weddings even.
Weddings?
Oh, yes. I've got to make a living, you
know. Oh, I see. You make a proper living out of this and a business out of this.
Oh, yeah. I don't do it for fun, you know.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, I mean, see, Bernard didn't tell me that. That he keeps you, on call, as it were.
Well, he doesn't. I have a lot of clients.
Yeah, what?
Yeah, he's a new one, actually.
Oh, my God.
What?
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's just...
There's a lot of people to cater for in today's society.
Yeah, well, there must be, I suppose.
Girls like me are in big demand.
Yeah, well, there must be, yes.
Yeah, that's why I went through an agency.
Agency? He found you through an agency?
Yeah.
A model indeed. Poor old Bernard.
What?
Yeah, oh, nothing. I must say, you're very mercenary about all this.
Well, why shouldn't I be? A girl's got to make a living. I don't do it for fun, you know.
Never do, train.
Right, where do we get started, then?
Well, we better start by my telling you something about myself.
Well,
who I am, etc.
Well, I know you are.
Yeah, but you need to know more. I mean, tonight's going to be one heck of an evening. This is a very delicate situation.
Delicate?
Yes, well, don't you see? I mean, his wife will be right there in the dining room.
Well, yes.
Well, so will Bernard.
And so will you.
Well, yes, I know I will be, but well, don't you see? I mean, one false move and the balloon could go on.
Oh, I see. She's...
Yes.
And he's...
Yes.
And you're...
Pig in the bloody middle.
This liaison's dangerous.
Yeah, very dangerous. Right, well, you better start. Look, let me explain a few things about myself. But sit down and listen very carefully.
Right.
Where do I start? Right. My name is Robert Dupinon.
Dupinon?
I live alone in Montmartre with two cats.
Cats?
I am divorced once and I'm 55 years old.
55 years old? You yes. Don't look 55 years old.
Oh, really? How old would you say I looked?
At least 65.
Yeah. I've had the flu. I was Bernard's best man.
Best man.
My pastimes are collecting rare stamps and squash.
Squash.
I drive a Citroen and I had my appendix out 6 months ago.
Why are you telling me all this?
What?
All your operations and everything.
Well, you'll need to know where my scars are at least.
Scars?
Yes, I mean if we're sleeping together.
What?
Share that room.
What room?
That room there.
How about that?
Well, in theory.
Theory?
Well, I'll sleep in the chair and then later I'll go over to the piggery.
The what?
The room over there. Look, I'm confused. Why are you surprised by all this?
Well, I wasn't planning on staying tonight.
Oh, I see. You intend to go home after dinner?
Well, yeah, I usually do. I haven't done the honours.
Well, doesn't matter. off directly after dinner, it would raise all sorts of awkward questions.
What do you mean?
Well, it's up to us to keep the thing going for the sake of their marriage.
Oh, I see. The delicate situation.
Yes, but Bernard told you all this on the phone.
Yeah, he did, but I didn't understand that she... I didn't know what was going on.
You didn't?
No, I was a bit slow on the uptake.
You certainly were.
So you want me to pretend to be your...
Yes.
And then no one will suspect anything?
Exactly.
Right. How do I know what to say?
Well, I've told you a few things, so you can always say those. Otherwise, it's probably best to say nothing. Unless someone says something to me, then you can always say nothing. Or you could say what I say to them.
Right. I think I'll be quiet.
Good. So, we all agree then, are we?
As long as it's only pretense.
Oh, good Lord, yes, I would make a play for you.
I'll go along with it, but I'm afraid it's an extra.
Extra?
It's not a usual part of my service, pretending to be someone else's.
Oh, no, but surely you want to say...
€50.
€50?
It's a very enough price for what's required.
But they're married, you don't want to see it all blown up, surely.
Don't really concern me, love.
Well, of all the hard...
Hang on a minute, I've got my reputation to think of.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it?
And a girl's got to make a living.
Well, I've heard of exploiting the market.
And it's not much for a whole shrub as well as spending the night with a strange man in a cow stall.
Oh, good Lord, I've never heard like it.
€50.
Oh, God.
Up front.
€50.
Right.
Very up front.
How's that settled? Where can I get out of these things?
What?
I've got to look the part and I can't do it dressed like this, can I?
What are you going to put on?
Well, I've got a little apron thing in here. I'll just slip into that.
Apron?
Well, it's very dinky. It covers from ear to ear.
Is that it?
Well, what more do I need?
No, don't need to do that.
It's
no, it's not a sort of relationship. No, I'm sorry. Maybe later. No, yes it is.
Don't mind us.
She's made it.
You look as if you were both making it. As well, you were going to introduce us?
Yes, Jackie, this is Susie. Susie, this is Jackie.
Hello. And this is my husband, Bernard. Bernard, do you know Robert's girlfriend, Susie?
Who? My girlfriend.
No, don't.
Did he have his girlfriend?
No, no.
Agency.
man, we're either happy.
No, sir.
Where's she going to pop to? No, neither do I.
That she'll be very happy to help out until the cook gets here. I'm sure Jacqueline would appreciate it. Then you're never happier than when you're in the kitchen. Jacqueline would appreciate the help, wouldn't she, Jacqueline?
I'd be overwhelmed. Just what am I supposed to do?
When the cook arrives, we'll sort that out when she comes. If she comes. Sidetrack.
Oh, I've had enough of this.
Frankly, about cooks, couldn't agree more. Very boring.
Very tedious.
Let's have no more of it.
Topic finished.
Banished from the conversation. Understand, Suzette?
Loved his death like
Suzette, yes. So.
And we sorted all that out.
Good.
Monday, Suzette.
Yes.
That's funny, the cook's name, Suzette.
Suzanne.
What?
The cook's name, Suzette.
I'm Suzette.
She's Suzette.
Oh, really? Funny, I'm sure they say Suzette. How do you know the cook's name?
Well, they told me yesterday when I booked the cook. Booked the cook!
Well, I took the call. They told me, I told you.
Listen, they told me yesterday. Very simple. Both called Susie for short. You just got the wrong way round, my dear.
Anyway, have you and your friend found where everything is apart from the bed?
Yes. I'd like to mention that.
The bed?
Yes. You see, I'm a very restless sleeper.
You are.
Like
what? So, Susie would rather sleep in the other room.
What?
Yes, that way I can get some. She can get some rest.
See, but it's the pillory.
She knows.
Oh, he's here.
So what have you got?
Well, I don't mean much in my job.
This is you, Robert.
What?
A model.
If you say so.
You say so.
A model, yes. Well, you've got the style for it.
Well, not only a model, an actress too. Yeah. A model and an actress.
Really? Well, I'm sure you're very suitable, Mr. Robert.
Oh, lovely.
Would you like to come
this way,
Miss
Susie?
Susie, I'll show you the piggery.
Just what am I supposed to
be? Just play your part, Susie. There's a girl.
Do I assume there's another cook coming to take my place?
Sure, Tom. You might say we're overcooked.
What?
What?
Playing actresses.
Extra.
€50.
What?
Jobs in my time, I can tell you.
Well done, Ring. Einstein couldn't have devised a better cock up.
But it's not my fault. You didn't tell me to cook to put her up! You told Susie's on her way, you said. Stay with me, you said. Find out all about her, you said.
Listen, you didn't, did you?
But I was too busy telling her about me.
So I noticed, right down to the appendix scar. A model, I said, a knockout. Did you look at her?
Oh, she's not that bad.
Not bad?
Good enough for what you want.
What, my friend? What? Anyway, how could you get her to play along with the scheme?
€50.
God, she's having a good night. That's what I gave her.
Yeah, at your age, you expect to pay for it.
What should I say? Oh, got it.
Still no cook?
No.
My.
What a good idea.
That's a very good idea.
I don't need any help.
Oh, she's a very good cook, darling.
How do you know?
Robert says so.
Expert. Brilliant.
Cordon bleu.
Really? Yes. Well, in that case.
Good. I can get back to something I understand.
Really? I've credited you with a little more taste.
God, wonderful. Now I'm the cook's lover.
Cook to cook.
This isn't funny, Bernard. This is a disaster.
Considering the situation, I think we're managing quite well.
So far.
Oh. Good evening. Oh, darling.
Jacqueline's in the kitchen.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good evening.
Welcome. Meet Suzanne.
Lovely to see you.
Oh, darling.
Happy birthday, Angel!
Thank you. I'm careful with my cups.
Well, don't worry. I know how much it cost. What took you so long?
Oh, it's this medieval place. There was only one taxi at the station and some chauvinist pig barge right in front of me and finished.
Oh, dear, I'm afraid that must have been me. If I'd realised...
What a shame. We could have shared.
That would have been nice. It would have saved a lot of problems.
Never mind. Listen carefully, darling. For reasons I haven't time to explain, we've had to change the plan.
Change the plan?
Yes. You're no longer his lover.
I'm not.
No.
Why not?
He's already got a lover.
A cook.
She's no longer the cook.
What is she?
She's you.
Me?
What you are supposed to be.
And what's that?
The cook.
I'm the cook? Oh, you're hero now. Do you know what time it is?
We were expecting you now, so.
You were?
Yes, what happened?
Well, I missed the...
Bus?
Well, it's not good enough. The agency should make sure you were here on time.
The agency?
Bon appetit.
Oh, thank you.
The catering agency, isn't that an obsession?
Of course it was.
Oh, yes, of course it was.
Good,
don't get angry, darling. Anyway, she's here now. We're very glad to see her. Everything's back to normal. So let's get on and enjoy the evening, okay?
Well, if you'd like to come this way, Miss...
Susie?
Oh, my word. What beautiful coat. Is this short?
No, it's too thick. I was just about to hang it up.
Chanel must have cost a fortune.
€5,000.
What?
Robert paid €5,000 for it. A birthday present for Suzette, wasn't it, Robert?
Oh, yes!
Well, happy birthday, Suzette.
Yes, happy birthday, Suzette.
Yes, happy birthday, Suzette.
Now I'm a fur guy. How do you want me off to chat,
Oh, you can leave all that now. The cook's here.
Good.
Yes, yeah, she's arrived at last. You can give her the apron.
Don't just give Susie here the apron.
Thanks very much. I can see this is going to be a wonderful evening.
I beg your pardon?
I'm going to make a wonderful evening for you, madam.
Right, well, carry on. We are having artichokes for sauce vinaigrette, cheese souffle, veal à la crème, and raspberry tableau. Right?
We are.
Yes.
And I'm cooking it.
Put the original terms of employment out of your head. We just want you to pretend for a few hours that you're Robert's girlfriend, who works as an actress and a model. You've come as our guest to enjoy a nice meal, stay overnight in a bed all to yourself, if that's your wish. And that's all you have to think about.
Right.
But please remember you are supposed to be a fairly sophisticated member of Paris society. That's too difficult.
What I mean to say is that my dear sir presents me with absolutely no problem whatsoever. I shall be delighted to comply with your eccentric desires. For the sake of a little extra consideration, shall we say the price of hors d'oeuvres at the Ritz?
Sounds like 50 euro to me.
God, you strike a hard bargain.
Right, very boring doing that all evening. Are you sure there's nothing I can do to help?
We'd be delighted for you to help, provided you remember it's in the role of a guest.
Oh, right. Right, that's got the dinner started. I need a drink.
Good idea. Susie?
Oh, I'd like a double Quattro frappe with a teeniest weeny slice of lemon.
Quattro?
It's the chic tipple with the Paris in crowd, don't you know?
No, I didn't.
Oh, you haven't lived.
Right. Double Quattro with lemon. Robert?
Quadruple vodka in a ice.
Oh, so much over loving you. Drinks, women, life, his mouth all with such style.
Oh yes, he's Superman. If it moves, zap it.
Go and drink your Quattro and get back to the kitchen.
So, Suave, are you sure there's nothing I can do to help you with your little soiree?
Very kind of you.
Perhaps you can help the other, Susie, darling. Two cordon bleus are better than one.
Well, I have to say the other ones are a bit of a loss in there.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you, too kind. I'll just trip into the kitchen and assist with the cuisine. Little aberration in your carpet there. I must give you the name of my head. He's in
wine. Some actress. What kind of a performance was that?
I told her to be on her best behaviour in your house, Jackie.
But if that's her best behaviour, I hope to see her when she lets her hair down.
There's yours down. Robert?
God, I need this.
If you do, that's an expensive lady you've got there.
Not ours.
5,000 euros for a coat. It's not my idea of a self-sufficient mistress.
Don't keep going on about the coat. You had a pair of gloves for Christmas.
Two pairs.
I seem to be redundant in there. Suzette's taken over.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I didn't mean
Never mind. If she's happy, there'll be plenty for Suzanne to do later. Come and have a drink, Suzanne.
That's the best suggestion I've heard so far.
Oh, by all means, give her a double Quattro frappe with just a teensy slice of lemon.
Sorry? No, I'll have my usual. Yes, my usual vodka martini, no ice,
a little vermouth, and an olive if you have it, please.
Good Lord. Sorry, did I say something wrong?
No, I just don't think that's the chic tipple with the Paris crowd.
Christ, Ada, can't you play your part a little more convincingly?
Well, I like that. I came down here for an intimate birthday dinner, and I end up skivvying for a large dinner party with people I don't even know.
Oh, you're going to have a fair job. We'll never be together, I promise you.
How?
We'll get Jackie and Totty. She always sleeps like a log after she's had a few. And then I can slip down and see you in the cow chair.
And will Robert be with us?
Certainly not. Kicking him off into the other room.
Oh, poor Robert.
Poor Robert? He was the cause of all this chaos in the first place.
My damn, it was. And it was your mother-in-law when he got through.
It was you who mistook the cook for my girlfriend.
It was you that cooked him up. What to cook in the first place? You're infested, you know, Jacqueline.
I'll just to go change my shirt. I wanted to clean up before dinner anyway.
Yes, and I'll get back to the kitchen and get on with my job.
And I'll just go and get another drink, I think.
I think you won't. You're going to be as pissed as a new by the time you sit down for dinner.
I need to be, believe me.
What you're worried about, you've got your hurry, you want a brunch.
Jacqueline, I promise you, things are not the way they seem.
Well, that's just as well, because they look pretty sordid to me.
Well, if you know Promusto, I think it's pretty sordid of us trying to get together under your roof with Bernard here.
Stop moralising at me. You don't mind when we're in Paris.
Well, that's different in Paris. But this is a very delicate situation. Oh,
it is. Oh, no, it looks to me like a delicate situation. Yes, I just came in to say, would you desire us to lay the table? I presume we're dining in there, what used to be the head house.
Oh, yes, it's very kind of you. You'll find everything you need in the oak side.
Leave it all to me. I'm used to chucking china around chicken coops.
We have the most eccentric taste.
I promise you she is not my woman.
Well, what is she then, your pet parrot?
No, it's just that she's at... Well, no, to be...
What?
She's my niece. She doesn't want to sleep with me, does she?
Well, she knows you're a restless sleeper. I know that. It certainly isn't because you're a member of the family.
No, but in her case it is. Look, Jackie, if she'd been my mistress, would I have brought her here tonight to mention?
You've got access to my mother.
Ah, but when I phoned you from the station, you told me you was going to make sure you were staying here. I would have put her on the first train back to Paris. Mm-hmm. There you are, see?
So why is she all over you with her macho lover act?
Well, it is an act. She's performing.
Why?
Well, she's an actress. When Bernard phoned me up and said I should come down for the weekend, he said I could bring a girlfriend with me. And I thought, well, why not? It'll put old Robert off the scent of any thing going on between you and going on between you and I. And so there you are.
Oh, so she's actually...
Yes.
She isn't really.
No.
Why didn't you tell me?
Well, Bernard was always around. I tried.
Darling, I was so relieved. I was really clever of you.
I thought so.
Oh, it looks to me like the delicate situation is getting more indelicate by the moment.
Oh, it's all right, Suzanne. I know all about you.
You do?
Yes, he's told me everything.
Everything?
Everything.
You mean you know that I'm...
My niece.
Subject to any further family revelations, developments.
I've got to go up and dress for dinner.
Right. Do I need to change?
No, you're fine in terms of clothes. Anyway, you're not going to be wearing them very long.
You're playing a very dangerous game. Uncle.
Yes, you don't have to tell me. But remember this, you're only my niece for her.
And what am I for them?
My mistress.
What's my for you?
The cook.
I should get an Oscar for this.
You're doing well enough, madam, as it is. And lay off those drinks. It's far too strong to be drinking before the dinner.
The stronger they come, the better I'm like.
I'm not at all sure I'm making this sauce
to meet broccoli. Velouté,
whatever it's called.
Don't look at me, my dear, you're the cook. I am certainly not the cook.
Then what are you doing here?
That is a very good question.
Girls, please, look, we just have to keep our parts going for a little bit longer.
A little bit longer? It looks as though I've got to serve everybody at dinner and be on the table as well. Don't you think you're up to it, my dear? It does take a certain slap off fair.
Yes, I'm up to it all
right. Now, girls, please. Look, we've just got to keep the pretense going for a bit. can't let him go, so just keep it going for a little bit more.
And why?
Yes, why?
Well, you're getting paid for it and you're getting labour. No, I didn't think that. What I meant is, well, you've made your bed and you've... No, no, I mean...
Oh, he is so sweet, adorable. Why can I meet a man like him?
Keep your hands off him, he's mine.
Get off of me, woman!
Right then, girls. Is everything set? Does everybody understand their roles?
Yes, and I'm not playing mine a lot longer.
Oh, you just dislove us, sweetheart. Then we'll be together, I promise you. Now, Suzette, there's just one more little thing.
Don't tell me. I'm your longest daughter, who's really a prima ballerina in disguise.
To spend the night in the piggery with three of your nephews in the prize ball.
Not quite. I want you to let Robert there share your room over there, so that Suzanne here can have that one over there.
That really is going to be expensive.
Still. Now, let's see, what can we do?
Oh, it does, Pat. It's probably best you're not knowing.
You know, it's, well, I get used to this, like, lover.
Uncle.
Poor young Quantro, lover.
You've had enough of that stuff.
Oh, I can recall my lovers under the table. Lover.
Uncle.
Oh, if you insist. Because you really are quite a dishy one. And after we're meant to be spending the night together, the people, it will be such a shame. How do you fancy it spotting me?
And your husband brought his mistress
course you don't know, do you? She's his niece.
Who?
Her, the ridiculous clockwork Barbie doll in the kitchen.
The cookie girlfriend.
She's not his girl. She's his niece, he told me before dinner.
Well, what's she doing here?
That's what I'm trying to tell you. She's actually my husband's mistress.
What?
Exactly, I told you I found proof.
What?
What?
Have you slept with her?
Oh, my God!
A letter from her to him.
Oh! Dear me.
Look.
She's with Robert.
Oh, no, that's just a front. Robert brought her to cover up the fact that she's actually sleeping with my husband.
The bastard!
Did you deny it?
Deny what?
Everything! didn't even know he had a niece. And how the hell can I be sleeping with his niece if I'm sleeping with you? And Robert's sleeping with his niece. Which he's not anyway.
Yes.
What do you mean, yes?
Yes, she is his niece. Yes, you are sleeping with her. And yes, you're a prize winner.
Oh,
shit. Your wife has told me all about it.
This is insanity. I'm going out of my mind. Wait a minute. You mentioned her lover.
Yes.
From you to me?
No, from her to you.
From Jacqueline to me?
No, from Robert's niece to you.
Ah, but she doesn't know about you and me.
Who doesn't know? Robert's niece.
And Jacqueline doesn't know.
Not as far as I know.
Thank God for that anyway.
Ah, but I know all about her.
What?
And in the circumstances, I think you should too.
What?
Well, she has a lover also.
Robert's niece has a lover?
No, you fool. Your wife.
How do you know?
She's just told me.
Don't believe it.
You see, it's not so funny when you're on the receiving end, is it?
Jacqueline has a lover?
Yes.
My little Jacqueline?
Yeah.
Who is it? I'll kill him. Why are you dressed for bed?
Well, I could ask you the same thing.
I think it's a very good idea. I'm exhausted. Does anybody mind if I look
at Christmas? Oh,
don't bring too much in.
Suzette! Come in here. Now, what's all this about the cook being your niece?
Suzanne's my niece?
Not that cook, this cook.
I thought that cook was my mistress.
So did I. Suzanne said you're your niece.
I don't have a niece.
I know that.
But how does Suzanne know?
What?
That Suzanne's my niece.
You just said you haven't got a niece.
I said that, but Jacqueline thinks I have.
Oh. Jacqueline thinks you have? Why does Jacqueline think that?
Because I didn't want my husband to know that Robert was my lover.
Yes, so you took what?
You have a husband?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You never mentioned him before.
Well, you never asked me.
Oh my God.
And as he'd probably kill Robert if he ever found out I was meant to be his lover, I thought...
Oh my God.
Everybody who didn't need to know thought he was my uncle instead.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Very clever of you, Suzette.
Very clever of you, Suzette.
Thank you. That'll be 50 euros.
Hold everything. I only give you this on the understanding that you ensure that your husband doesn't kill me.
Oh, he hasn't killed anyone yet.
Good.
Just broken a few bones.
Oh, my God.
What I still don't understand is this business of me having an affair with your niece.
With who?
Your niece.
I don't have a niece.
Oh, for God's sake.
Who are you having an affair with now?
You.
Me? You're having an affair with me?
Yes.
Don't muck about, do you?
That's what Jacqueline thinks.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
Why?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
Well, when you do, would you let me know? Because I'd want to know, and so would my husband.
I think I could help you, actually.
You could?
Yes. You see, Jacqueline thinks you're having an affair with Suzette because she found the note that Suzanne gave to you for the coat you gave to Suzanne, which she thinks we gave to Suzette.
What?
Something like that, anyway.
She found the note?
Yes.
Oh, I see.
Good.
Neither.
Why not?
Why did she give the note to me?
Well, she found it in your jacket pocket.
Ah, I see.
Good.
Neither.
Why not?
Why did she take the note from Suzette?
Because she thinks we gave the coat to Suzette.
Oh, I see.
Good.
No, I don't.
Why not?
What was she doing going through my jacket pockets for in the first place?
Why shouldn't she? I always go through my husband's jacket pockets.
My wife's not like that. She trusts me. Stupid woman.
And she found it when she was hanging it up to dry.
Thoughtful woman.
Yes, and an angry woman too.
I'm beginning to understand. Now that's why she dashed me with the soda siphon.
Oh, you too, eh?
What do you mean, me too?
Oh, he means this. She did the same to me.
Well, soda all down your front.
Worth ice.
Well, why?
Well, probably the same reason. She thinks you and I are having an affair.
I see.
No wonder she's cross.
Wait a minute. What right has she to be cross?
What?
I'm the one who should be cross. In fact, I should be furious. In fact, I am.
What?
She has only an insignificant little note to go on. That could mean anything. I have proof.
Proof of your affair?
No, her affair, you fool.
Her affair?
I know all about it.
You do?
What's going on right under my nose? And I can tell you, I'm hopping mad.
Oh, my God.
Lord.
You may well say, oh, God, my friend. I never knew how much it would affect me, but it's made me so mad. I could do unmentionable things.
Oh, Lord.
Lord.
Can you imagine what it's like? Your own wife, who you've trusted all these years. Oh, I never thought I was capable of murder, but I am now.
Murder, you mustn't get taken. Just calm down.
Oh, why?
You, I know it must be very painful, but you mustn't get carried away.
Carried away? Oh, I'm not the one who's going to get carried away.
Bernie,
I can't tell you. When I find out who he is, I'm going to have his private parts pickled and pinned up in a picture frame in the piggery.
Oh, very nasty. When you find out who it is?
Yes.
You mean you don't know who it is?
Of course, don't you think he'd still be alive if I did?
Oh, I see.
You think he'd still be in one piece?
Oh, thank God for that.
Of course. I'm about to, just as soon as I find out who he is.
But you still don't know who he is.
Of course not. Is that all you can say? You know someone is sleeping with my wife behind my back, and all you can say is, phew.
Ah, yes, well, the swine.
Exactly.
That bastard.
That getter.
He deserves all he
gets. And he's going to get it. I'm going to have his private part.
Yes, yes,
pinned up in the piggery.
Yes, you told us.
Oh.
Right, I've thought it all through. It's time to have everything out front.
Yes, please.
The time when you were subterfuge, I know all about you.
Who?
You. And her.
What about me and her?
She isn't Robert's girlfriend, she's his niece.
Here we go again.
She's having an affair with him. She's having one with you.
It's like a record. I don't deny anything. I've never been so many different people and had so many different affairs with so many different men. It's quite nice to be popular.
You see?
Jacqueline, darling, I think you've got hold of the wrong end of the stick.
Oh, I think we know who's got hold of who, which end of whose stick.
How rude.
I know all about you. I think it's about time you knew all about me.
What?
Suzanne, would you mind leaving now, please?
Eh?
There are some things I wish to divulge about your family. I think it's best you don't hear about.
By all means. The more I get to know what little I knew in the beginning, the less chance I have of understanding what happens in the end.
Not that bad.
I owe you a particular.
No, I don't. Whatever gave you such an idea?
I found proof.
What proof?
Thank you for the gorgeous, gorgeous coat. Gorgeous, gorgeous man.
I don't know what you're talking about. Do you know what you're talking about?
Oh, he knows what I'm talking about, right? I mean, you don't give gorgeous, gorgeous coats to your girlfriend, do you, Robert?
Jacqueline?
You give rotten pairs of gloves.
Some jolly nice gloves.
What have gloves got to do with it?
Sorry.
And what did you mean just now when you said I should know the truth about you?
Well, darling.
Jacqueline?
Haven't we always said that marriage should be an equal partnership?
Yes, of course.
So if you were to have a mistress, it's only fair that I should have another.
Jacqueline?
Quiet you.
Isn't it?
Well, I suppose if it were true that I had a mistress,
yes.
As a purely hypothetical situation, then I suppose it could be considered that you could have a theoretical right to have a figurative lover.
Thank you.
Jacqueline!
So since I know about your mythical mistress, I think it's about time you knew about my illusory lover.
Jacqueline!
You mean you have got a lover?
Yes.
Who is it? I'll kill him.
Who is
it? I'll castrate him. Who is it?
Oh, God!
Exactly.
Robert?
Yes?
Is this true?
Nonsense!
Is it possible?
It's not!
Because if it is...
Now, Bernard, it is. And even if it was, you wouldn't. Because it wouldn't be fair. Because, really, I'd be no worse than you. If I was, not that I am, of course.
Pickle! No. I'm taking it. Who's that?
Oh, I know.
Do you know?
No, I'll be very pleased to see them.
Oh, stay where you are, you.
I come straight around.
Who?
The cook.
Yeah. I thought she was staying the night.
What would she do that for?
Well, it's awfully late.
Always fetch her. That way she can't get into trouble, know what I mean?
Yeah,
of course, if she's not quite finished, I'm quite happy to wait seeing as you celebrate it.
Maybe ask who you are exactly.
I'm George.
George?
Her husband.
Oh, God!
I work as a chef too, you say?
Oh, right, how fascinating.
And when I've finished, I come along to see if Susie's finished. Oh, yeah. Is she finished?
We're all bloody finished.
Good. Are you the mistress?
It depends on your meaning.
If it was me, I'd bloody kill him.
I was just about to, actually.
You want in here?
You'll let you know if I do.
Right. Well, if she's finished, where is she?
I don't know. Where is she, Bernard?
Who?
Susie, of course.
She's gone.
Gone?
Yeah. Finished, is she?
Left.
She might have gone.
Why not?
She knew I was coming.
Perhaps that's why she left.
I'm being alive!
Perhaps she left to meet you on the way?
She never goes when she knows I'm coming. She must be here.
Perhaps she's upstairs.
Upstairs?
Susie.
What's she doing upstairs?
I can't imagine.
How the fuck is?
Yes, here she is. Why did you say she left?
What's yours look like?
My Susie's about this high. about this wide, with a long black skirt and a high white blouse.
Yes, I must say.
With a very short skirt.
And a very low top.
Nah, that can't be my Susie. If my Susie ever dressed like that, I'd bloody kill her.
Oh, it's definitely not your Susie.
I should try the other houses.
Yes, there's lots of houses around here, all look exactly the same.
Dinner parties going on all over the place.
People stuffing their faces left, right and centre.
Anything else? That's that lot finished.
Susie!
Georgie!
I knew you were here.
Of course I knew, flower.
I knew you wouldn't have gone.
Where?
These people, they seem to think...
Hang
on a minute.
Oh, here we go.
First of all, they said you were gone.
No, I was still here.
Then they said you were upstairs.
No, I was in there.
Then they said you were in another house doing dinner.
No, this house.
So what was that nonsense about then?
Ah, well, you see,
And further, then she says you're an actress.
No, I'm a cook.
She also said that you were this man's mistress.
No, don't be ridiculous.
She also said that you were this man's uncle.
Of course not.
You've been a great help, hasn't she, Robert?
A lifesaver.
You like you, Howard, I'll just
get my things. You're all ready for bed anyway.
Yes, we just haven't decided who's going to bed.
Yes.
you giving a coat to the cook?
No, I wasn't. I was giving it to Suzanne.
Suzanne?
Yes.
Oh, see. No, I...
Yeah, why not?
Well, you said it was the cook's.
Yeah, well, I was giving it to Suzanne when you thought that she was the cook.
Oh, I see.
Good.
No, I said.
Yeah, why not?
Well, the cook's gone off wearing it.
Ah, well, I said... Suzette could have the coat, proposing as my mistress and my niece. I'll buy Suzanne another one.
Thank you.
Oh, it's nothing. Yeah, oh, God, honestly.
See?
Good.
No, I don't.
Yeah, why not?
It doesn't explain what the papers were doing in Bernard's jacket pocket.
Well, I was leaving them there for safekeeping, so my mistress wouldn't find them.
My other mistress.
Because Suzanne is your mistress, so why were you worried about her finding the papers?
My other mistress.
You mean the cook when she was being your mistress?
That's it, yeah, the cook.
Yes, that makes
sense.
Right, so are we all happy now?
Yes, I think that's it. I can't think of anything else.
Good.
I think it's time you went to bed. I'm shattered.
Thank the Lord for that. Well, thank you for a lovely evening. I'm so glad I came.
Are you?
Yes. I'm so pleased that we've all kept our friendships after a rather difficult evening. I think it's very important we all keep our friendships, don't you?
Yes, I suppose so.
Good. Well, good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Oh, good night. Isn't Suzanne going with you?
Well, I'm a very restless sleeper, you know.
You are.
Suzanne would rather sleep by herself.
I would, yes. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Oh, dear old Robert.
Yes, dear old Robert.
You know, I've got the feeling you rather fancied him tonight.
Robert? No. My type at all. Thought you quite fancied her, though.
What? Suzanne? No, not my type. Sure you're that.
Sweetheart, I don't think it was a good idea to invite them both for the weekend.
You don't?
No. These single people, they lead such unsettled lives. It's very disturbing for us happily married ones.
Yes, it is, I suppose.
Yes, they should do their cavorting elsewhere.
We've got all we need.
We have.
Let's go to bed.
Let's.
Go on, get up those stairs.
Oh,
go on, quick.
Messy sleeper.
Really? Well, who said about getting any sleep?
After all, you do deserve a reward.
Reward what for?
Finally, another gorgeous girl.